Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the subject Internal Combustion Engine. This is lecture number 15, Problems in IC Engine. So, we recap from the previous lecture. So, in the previous lecture, we studied about the testing of IC engine. The equations for various performance parameters we have discussed. And we solved few problems in the earlier lecture. And this lecture also we continue with the problem in the IC engines. And the learning outcome is the students will be able to solve problem at the end of the lecture in the IC engine. So, we continue. So, problem number 5 from November 2009 question paper. A 12-cylinder 4-stroke cycle marine gasoline engine with 163 millimeter bore and 165 millimeter stroke delivers 895 kilowatt at 2400 rpm while burning 576.46 liters of fuel per hour. The fuel weight is 0.743 kilograms per liter. The engine produces 1119 kilowatt of indicated power. Find the brake mean effective pressure, indicated mean effective pressure, brake specific fuel consumption and the mechanical efficiency. So, write down the given data. So, number of cylinders K equal to 12. It is a 4-stroke cycle engine. Diameter is 0.163 meter. Stroke length is 0.165 meter. Brake power is 895 kilowatt. Speed equal to 2400 rpm. Mass of the fuel is 576.46 liters per hour. And density of the fuel is 0.743 kilograms per liter. Indicated power is 1119 kilowatts. First, we calculate the brake mean effective pressure. So, brake mean effective pressure equal to brake power divided by ALNK. So, A is the area, L is the stroke length, N is the number of explosions per second, and K is the number of cylinders. So, this is brake power divided by A equal to pi by 4 d square L into N equal to N by 2. This is 4-stroke cycle engine. So, small n equal to capital N divided by 2 into number of cylinders K. So, substitute numerical values. 895 brake power is 895 kilowatts. Pi by 4 into 0.163 square into 0.165 into speed equal to 2400 rpm. So, divided by 2 into 60 into 12 cylinder engine into 12. So, calculating. It is 1083.6 kilopascal. So, the brake mean effective pressure is 1083.6 kilopascal. Similarly, the indicated mean effective pressure PIM equal to IP by ALNK. So, again IP by pi by 4 d square L into N by 2 into K. So, the numerator is IP 1119. Substituting all the numerical values, pi by 4 into d equal to 0.163 square. Into 0.165 into 2400 divided by 2 into 60 into 12 equal to 1354.8 kilopascal. So, indicated mean effective pressure is 1354.8 kilopascal. Mass of the fuel equal to, so mass of the fuel we are given in liters per hour. So, we have to convert into kilogram per hour. So, 576.46 divided by the density of the fuel, which is 775.85 kilograms per hour. So, brake specific fuel consumption. So, BSFC equal to mass of the fuel divided by the brake power, which is 775.85 divided by 895 equal to 0.867 kilogram per kilowatt hour. So, for the engine, the mass of the fuel divided by the brake power equal to 0.867 kilograms per kilowatt hour. And the mechanical efficiency, eta mechanical equal to brake power by indicated power into 100, which is 895 divided by 1119 into 100 equal to 80%. So, these are all the questions in the problem. We have solved all the, we have calculated all the parameters in the question paper. Next problem, problem number 6. Air consumption for a 4-stroke petrol engine is measured by means of a circular orifice of diameter 3.2 centimeter. The coefficient of discharge of the orifice is 0.62. And the pressure across the orifice is 150 millimeter of water. The barometer reads the atmosphere pressure as 760 millimeter of mercury. The temperature of the air at the room condition 20 degrees Celsius. The piston displacement volume, stroke volume is 0.00178 meter cube. The compression ratio is 6.5. The fuel consumption is 0.135 kilograms per minute and the calorific fuel is 43,900 kilojoules per kilogram. Brake power produced at 2500 rpm is 28 kilowatts. Determine volumetric efficiency of on the basis of air alone, air fuel ratio, brake mean effective pressure and relative efficiency on the brake thermal efficiency basis. So, this is again from the November 2009 question paper. So, we write down the given data. This is a performance test. 4-stroke cycle engine. Diameter of the orifice equal to 0.032 meter. Coefficient of discharge equal to 0.62. Delta P across the orifice 150 millimeter of water. Pressure, atmosphere pressure is 760 millimeter of mercury, which is 101.325 kilopascal. Temperature of the air 293 Kelvin, 20 degree Celsius, which is 293 Kelvin. And the stroke volume is 0.00178 meter cube. Compression ratio is 6.5. Mass of the fuel is 0.135 kilograms per minute, which is 2.25 in 10 power minus 3 kilograms per second. Calorific value is 43,900 kilojoules per kilogram. Brake power is 28 kilowatts and the speed equal to 2500 rpm. Now, the density of the air, so rho a equal to pa by r into ta, so 101.325 divided by 0.287 into 293 equal to 1.2 kilograms per meter cube. And the pressure difference across the orifice in terms of air column. So, we are given in terms of water column. We have to convert in terms of air column. So, delta P air column equal to delta P water column in density of water divided by density of the air. So, 0.15 into density of water is 1000 divided by 1.2 equal to 125 meter of air column. And actual volume flow rate of air. So, VA equal to area of the orifice. Coefficient of discharge into the velocity square root of 2g into delta PA. So, pi by 4 d square into cd into square root of 2g delta PA. So, pi by 4 into 0.032 square and cd equal to 0.62 into square root of 2.982 into 9.81 into 125 equal to 0.025 meter cube per second. And the mass of the air equal to MA equal to VA, volume of air into density of the air. So, 0.025 into 1.2 equal to 0.03 kilograms per second. And we calculate the theoretical volume flow rate of air. So, V theoretical equal to Vs, swept volume into N by 2 into 60, which is 0.00178 into 2500 divided by 2 into 60 equal to 0.037 meter cube per second. Now, we will calculate the volumetric efficiency. So, volumetric efficiency equal to VA by V theoretical. So, VA we calculated here 0.025. So, 0.025 divided by 0.037 into 100 equal to 67.5%. And the air fuel ratio AFR equal to MA by MF. So, mass of the air equal to actual mass of the air equal to 0.03 divided by mass of the fuel equal to 2.25 in 10 power minus 3 equal to 13.3. So, air fuel ratio is 13.3. And the brake mean effective pressure, so PBM equal to brake power divided by stroke volume into N into K. So, brake power divided by stroke volume, small n equal to capital N by 2 for 4-stroke cycle engine and K is the number of cylinders. So, 28 divided by 0.00178 into 2500 divided by 2 into 60 into 1 equal to 755 kilopascal. And the brake thermal efficiency is BP divided by mass of fuel into calorific value into 100. So, 28 divided by 2.25 in 10 power minus 3 into 43,900 into 100 equal to 28.3%. So, the brake thermal efficiency is 28.3%. Aston efficiency for the gasoline engine. So, eta A equal to based on the auto cycle 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 1 minus 1 by 6.5 to the power 0.4 equal to 0.527, which is 52.7%. And relative efficiency equal to brake thermal efficiency divided by the air standard efficiency into 100. So, 0.283 divided by 0.527 into 100 equal to 53.7%. So, we calculated all the parameter here and we proceed to the next problem. The next problem, seventh problem from the November 2010 question paper. The following data relate to a 4-cylinder 4-stroke petrol engine. Air fuel ratio by weight is 16:1. Calorific value of the fuel is 45,200 kilojoules per kilogram. Mechanical efficiency equal to 82%. Air standard efficiency is 52%. relative efficiency is 70%, volumetric efficiency is 78%, stroke to the bore ratio, L by D ratio is 1.25, suction conditions are 1 bar 25 degrees Celsius, speed equal to 2400 RPM, power produced by the brake power equal to 72 kilowatts, calculate the compression ratio, indicated thermal efficiency, brake specific fuel consumption, bore and the stroke, that is diameter and the stroke length. And we are given K equal to 4, number of cylinder equal to 4, 4 stroke engine, air fuel ratio, mass of air divided by mass of fuel equal to 16, calorific value 45,200 kilojoules per kilogram, mechanical efficiency is 0.82, air standard efficiency is 0.52, relative efficiency is 0.7, 70%, volumetric efficiency is 0.78, L by D ratio is 1.25, atmospheric pressure is 1 bar, atmospheric temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, speed of the engine is 2400 RPM, and the brake power equal to 72 kilowatts. So, first we calculate the compression ratio. So, from the definition of air standard efficiency, air standard efficiency is 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1. So, from the equation, 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1 equal to 1 minus eta A. So, substituting 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1 equal to 1 minus 0.52 equal to 0.48. So, R to the power 0.4 equal to 2.08 and the compression ratio equal to 6.2. So, for this petrol engine, the compression ratio is 6.2 and the brake thermal efficiency is relative efficiency into air standard efficiency. Based on the given data, brake thermal efficiency equal to relative efficiency into air standard efficiency. So, 0.7 into 0.52 equal to 0.364, which is 36.4%. And mass of the fuel consumed. So, from the definition of brake thermal efficiency, mass of the fuel equal to brake power divided by brake thermal efficiency into calorific value. So, 72 divided by 0.364 into 45,200 equal to 4.37 and 10 power minus 3 kilograms per second. And mass of the air. So, the air fuel ratio is given as 16. So, mass of air equal to 16 into 4.3 and 10 power minus 3 equal to 0.0699 kilograms per second. And indicated thermal efficiency. So, this is IP by MF into CV. We divide both numerator and denominator by mechanical, we divide the IP equal to brake power by mechanical efficiency. So, IP equal to brake power by mechanical efficiency divided by mass of fuel into calorific value. So, substituting brake power is 72, mechanical efficiency is 0.82 and mass of fuel is 4.37 10 power minus 3 and calorific value is 45,200. So, which gives 0.444, which is 44.4%. So, this indicated thermal efficiency. So, we have to calculate the brake specific fuel consumption. BSFC equal to mass of the fuel divided by the brake power, which is 4.37 10 power minus 3 into 3600 divided by 72 equal to 0.2185 kilograms per kilowatt hour. And we calculate the density of the air. So, density of the air for the atmospheric condition, rho A equal to PA by R into TA. So, 100 kilopascal pressure, 0.287, R equal to 0.287, temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, 298 Kelvin, which is 1.17 kilograms per meter cube. Actual volume of air equal to mass of air divided by the density of the air, which is 0.0699 divided by 1.17 equal to 0.06 meter cube per second. And theoretical volume of air, V theoretical equal to VA by volumetric efficiency. So, 0.06 divided by 0.78 equal to 0.077 meter cube per second. And this theoretical efficiency, theoretical volume of air equal to pi by 4 D square L into N by 2 into K. So, the left hand side is 0.077, pi by 4 into D square, L equal to 1.25 times of D into N by 2 is 2400 divided by 2 into 60, number of cylinder equal to 4. So, left hand side as it is 0.077, right hand side we calculate all the numerical values, combine all the numerical data, it is 78.5 into D to the power 3. So, solving this, diameter of the cylinder equal to 0.099 meter and the stroke length is, which is 1.2 times of the diameter, which is 0.124 meter. So, diameter is stroke length equal to 1.24 times of 1.25 times of the diameter 0.099 equal to 0.124 meter. So, the Next problem. Problem number, example number 8 from the November 2012 question paper. So, the compression curve of an indicator diagram for a gas engine follows the law PV to the power 1.3 equal to constant. At two points on the curve, 1 by 4 of the stroke and 3 by 4 of the stroke, the pressure measured as 1.4 bar and 3.6 bar respectively. Determine the compression ratio of the engine. Calculate the thermal efficiency and gas consumption per IP hour if the relative efficiency is 0.4. The gas has the calorific value of 18,800 kilojoules per meter cube. So, this is from November 2012 question paper. This is a gas engine. And look at this problem. So, we are given the PV diagram. So, from the PV diagram, we are measuring the volume at two locations. 1 by 4th of the stroke. So, we assume the stroke volume from the BDC to TDC. So, we measure V1, 1 by 4th of the stroke, 0.25 Vs. Vs is the stroke volume, V1 is the volume here at the 0.1. V2, at the second point, we measure the V2 is 0.75 times of the stroke. So, 3 by 4 of the stroke, 0.75 times of the stroke is the second point. In the first point, the pressure is 1.4 bar. In the second point, the pressure is 3.6 bar. Now, this is the PV diagram. For the compression process. Now, the compression ratio, we have R equal to V1 by V2, which is P2 by P1 to the power 1 by gamma. V1 by V2, this V1 by V2 equal to V1 equal to 0.25 times of Vs and V2 equal to 0.75 times of Vs, which is 0.33 times of V1 by V2 equal to P2 by P1 to the power 1 by gamma, which is 3.6 divided by 1.4 to the power 1 by 1.3 equal to 2.07. So, P2 is substituted, P1 is substituted, we calculate this is 2.07, that is 0.33 V1 by V2 equal to 2.07. So, V1 by V2, which is compression ratio, equal to 2.07 divided by 0.33 equal to 6.3. So, the compression ratio for this engine, the gas engine, is 6.3. Now, the air standard efficiency eta A equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1. Which is 1 minus 1 by R to the power R equal to 6.3 to the power 0.4 equal to 0.52, which is 52%. And the indicator thermal efficiency, indicator thermal efficiency equal to relative efficiency into air standard efficiency. So, 0.4 into 0.52 equal to 0.208, which is 20.8%. And then we calculate the gas consumption per IP hour. So, again we define this formula. Indicator thermal efficiency equal to IP divided by MF into CV. I take the IP to the denominator. So, 1 divided by MF into IP, MF divided by IP into CV, and this ratio is the specific fuel consumption based on the indicator power. Indicated specific fuel consumption into calorific value. So, from here, from this equation, ISFC equal to 1 by indicator thermal efficiency into calorific value. So, which is equal to 1 divided by 0.208 into 18,800, which is 2.557 in 10 power minus 4 meter cube per kilowatt second. So, we have to convert into kilowatt hour. So, multiply this by 3600. So, 2.557 in 10 power minus 4 into 3600 equal to 0.92 meter cube per kilowatt hour. So, we have calculated all the parameters for this problem. So, we stop here. And these are all the reference books I used for the preparation of the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information. And I have published a book on thermal engineering. You can refer to it for additional information or additional problems. And thank you for watching. You please comment on your, you comment on the YouTube video comment box so that I will improve the video and further. So you subscribe my YouTube channel. So I have uploaded more than 200 videos on the thermal engineering subjects. So, you can write to my mail ID for any clarification or WhatsApp to my number. I will sincerely answer. So, thank you for watching and we will meet again in the next lecture with some more additional problems from the Anna University question paper on internal combustion engine. Thank you for watching. I will meet again.